Hello, everyone.
Hello, Drink Tranquil. Are you packed and ready to go?
I'm going to pack tonight. My wife's going to help me. Her mother came in town. My mother-in-law can help us with the kids, going to help me get my suitcase packed, my outfits, and we'll be off and rolling.
So what do you got to take when you go to a place like Germany?
I don't know. I've never been, but my wife's dad, my father-in-law, is from Belgium, so he's got a little Europe background in the family, so I'll have to call him and ask.
What do you know about Frankfurt? Germany in general, what do you know?
I don't know too much, and I'm really excited to find out.
You know about Tyreek Hill a lot. I mean,
he's very fast.
Yeah, you chased him around a bit. Yeah. Just go back into your little memory there and just the matchups battling, going up against him, and you know, what did you learn and what can you take from that you can put into this game?
He's really fast. He's really good after the catch. You got to take good angles. He's a great competitor, and at any given moment, we had a play last year where we were playing really well, playing good defense against the Dolphins. We force a fumble, the ball's like in the pile, it shoots out, and Tyreek, literally, we blink our eyes and he took it 75 to the house. It's like, man, you have a play where you force a turnover and then this guy creates. And so it's just like that for four quarters or however long it goes.
Drew, do you feel like he's a different player in any way than he was when he was playing for the Chiefs, when you used to play against him then?
I mean, I'm sure they're finding creative ways to use him with motions in. There's this like out motion thing that's become a popular thing in the NFL. But man, he's still the same fast, elusive Tyreek Hill that I remember.
What's the best way to get to Tua?
Well, he gets the ball quick. He's good with his decision making. I think it's going to be a rush and coverage working together. Like if we just give him quick rhythm throws, the D-line is never going to have a chance to get there. He's got one of the quickest releases in the NFL, just statistically. And so we're going to have good coverage on the back end and make it a one-dimensional game. If they're allowed to run the ball and set up their play actions, it's going to be tough. But if we can get ahead, if we can get three and outs, get Pat the ball, and create a one-dimensional game where he's got to drop back, we'll have a better shot.
You guys started the season probably with one of the deeper linebacker rooms in the league, and now it's really getting tested. How do you feel like you guys can hold up, especially since you're going to be the guy calling these plays?
Yeah, I think we can hold up well. I think we got great personnel in that room. I think we've got a great leader in Coach Brendan Daly, and I think they do a great job of putting us in good positions. And obviously, we're deep in that room. We've got good experience. And so, you know, as guys heal, we're going to have other guys step up, and we'll certainly continue to do that.
I know the culture of this team is not one that the offense is mad at the defense, the defense is mad at the offense, right? The offense had a tough day, we know it. They turned the ball over. But just the frustration, it looked like Pat even had a moment where, like, you know, he ran into Donovan and went down, and you kind of saw his head slump and kind of toss the ball. Like, when you keep having to go back out there, right? Like, and you know, is there a, you know, do you have to pick yourself up? Is there one guy on the team that's kind of the, you know, tries to get everybody back up, or does it eventually, the way it just kept going wrong for you against Denver, does it eventually wear everybody down and you kind of see guys start hanging their heads?
Yeah, I don't know. As a player, I think you see it more as like an opportunity. Like, man, we got to win this game on defense today. Like, it's not going the right way. And there's moments like that when the offense is like, man, our defense is struggling. We got to win the game on offense. And so it's a cool thing about football. It's a team game. And so, like, week to week, you have to win games differently. Weather elements can play a factor in that. And so we saw it as a challenge, as an opportunity. We obviously started in some unfavorable, you know, field positions, but I don't know. At least me personally, I see it like, man, like let's be the reason today, like we win the game.
Have you traveled and played in an international game before?
I did Mexico City my rookie year.
What is the, you know, that the travel isn't as long as it will be to Frankfurt, but have you found a way to kind of not let tiredness and the long travel get to you? I mean, drinking green tea or doing something. Is there something you do when travel is a major part of the trip?
I mean, I think there's obviously factors that, you know, like dehydration and sleep will be critical. But like I said, I've never, you know, overseas this way. And so it'll be new to me. It's going to be new to a lot of our guys. And it's just a part of our job. We're pro athletes. We got to find a way. And I don't think we're going to have an issue being juiced up and ready to go this Sunday.
Drew, when your quarterback's not feeling 100% and reportedly had the flu, what does it mean to you and some of your teammates to see him out there battling that and still try to push his way through to help you guys win?
Well, I think it just speaks to Pat's character. I mean, he's a competitor. He wants to be the best, wants to be the greatest. And, you know, you see that each and every Sunday. He's going to do everything he can to be out there.
And when you go to Germany, is there anything you go on the checklist that you want to try or do?
Well, like I mentioned, my father-in-law, who's from Belgium, he lives in Croatia now, but he's going to be out there. I'll get to see him, and hopefully he'll take me to a good restaurant or something.
Drew, I'm not trying to get you in trouble here, but from my perspective, I have no idea what's holding and not holding on receivers, what's pass interference and what isn't. It seems very arbitrary, mm-hmm. game to game. I know Andy's talked about the, you know, the team scouts the officials, so you kind of know, hey, they call this, they call that. How accurate is the scouting report on them for what you see end up playing? Like I said, from my vantage point, it seems very arbitrary, no matter what team's playing.
Yeah.
Do you feel like you go in, you got a pretty good read on what they are, and does that end up being accurate, or does every game look to you like it looks to me, like, I don't know what they're calling?
Yeah, I don't know. I think, it varies crew to crew. Like, sometimes crews emphasize offensive holding. Sometimes crews, emphasize illegal man downfield. I think it, too, is a week-to-week thing. Like, the media gets up in arms about a certain call in a game, and then the NFL is going to emphasize that and put that on their officials' tape. So I think it varies. There's ebbs and flows. They got a tough job. We got a tough job, too, as players. And so at the end of the day, everyone wants to win. The officials want to get it right. We as players want to get it right. And it's just a tough deal,
Have you ever been burned in your career because you didn't want to hit a quarterback, even though he might be scrambling, you didn't want to hit him because he's a quarterback? Have you ever been burned by that?
I don't know that I've ever encountered that. No, I think I've had one where I hit on him too hard and I got, a sack or, a TFL taken away, but not that I can recall.
Does it change your preparation at all defensively when you're facing a left-handed quarterback, or does it not matter that much?
I mean, they'll just have offensive tendencies. Maybe their boot game is switched one way. They like to go to our right instead of our left, which we see in a typical week. But, certainly, like, when you're mirroring the quarterback's hand, like, I'm not going to be using my left hand. I'm going to be using, my right hand. And so just small things like that.
Last one.
Drew, with a player like Tyreek that has the speed that he does, or is it just kind of jarring from time to time?
Yeah, I don't know that you get used to it. Like I said, it's you might have good angles for two quarters, and then you take a bad angle, and he cuts back and reverses field, and you got a big hand. So it's it's not just him. They've got Jalen Waddle, they got Raheem Mostert, they've got all types of speed. So it's gonna be a challenge. It's gonna be fun though.
Thank you, everybody.
Yeah, thanks, guys.
Thank you.